There are standard ways for solving equations, substitution, elimination, you know it. And then there are clever ways for solving equations. Techniques so simplistic, yet so powerful, that completely transform equations. We'll be exploring these clever techniques. Let's start off with this example. Suppose x, y, and z are real numbers that satisfy x plus y minus z is 5. Y plus z minus x is 7. Z plus x minus y is 9. Find x squared plus y squared plus z squared. Interesting. So you could go about substitution, elimination, whatever, but is there anything else we can do here? The key idea here is notice that all three equations, they look very, very similar, don't they? X plus y minus z. Oh, this time it's x, y plus z minus x. This time it's z plus x minus y. It's like they're all the same equation with the different variables shifted, right? Interesting. What if we rewrite the equations as follows? What if you rewrite this equation as x plus y plus z minus 2z? And this equation as y x plus y plus z minus 2x, right? Because x minus 2x is negative x equals 7. Or x plus y plus z minus 2y equals 9. Interesting. We've got a bunch of x plus y plus z's. So now what we can actually do is add all three of these equations up together. And what does that give us? 3x plus y plus z, right? 1, 2, 3. And then minus 2, that's also x plus y plus z. And that's equal to 5 plus 7 plus 9, 21. So x plus y plus z is 21. Oh, wow, that's so cool. We just basically added the three equations up and we were left with such a nice, simple expression. But the question is, how can we use it to find this? How can we use it to solve for x, y, and z? Oh, we can just subtract. Aha. Notice here how x plus y plus z is 21. So that means this expression over here is just equal to 21 minus 2z. So 21 minus 2z is 5. That means 16 is 2z, or z is 8. So z is 8. Let's do the same thing again, because it worked. 21 minus 2x is 7. 14 is 2x. X is 7. Cool. And for this one, we have 21 minus 2y is 9. So 2y is 12. Y is 6. So x, 7. Y, 6. And z, 8. Very cool. Okay, so now the question is, now all we have to do is just plug it in. 49 plus 36 plus 64, that's 149. Cool. So the key idea here was noticing that symmetry, and that symmetry is a property we'll be using to solve many more equations. It's definitely something you should always be on the lookout for, as it's very powerful. Okay, so now we're on to another cool equation. This one seems scary. X plus y times y plus z equals 36. Okay, x plus z, x plus y equals 4. Compute y squared minus x squared. Wait, we have three variables but only two equations. This is impossible. Oh, but the thing is, we don't want have to solve for any variable. We just want this expression, that's all. Another important problem-solving technique. You don't always have to find every variable. Sometimes you can just find an expression in terms of them without finding y and x individually. Cool, so, what is y squared minus x squared? Does it look like anything familiar to you? Any factorization, identity, difference of squares? Yeah, difference of squares. A squared minus b squared, a minus b, a plus b. Same thing, y minus x, Y plus X. This is an identity worth knowing. Okay, so interesting. But still, this is still, how do we get this? Y minus X, Y plus X. So now a common temptation many people have is just to expand this out. XY plus XZ plus Y squared plus YZ. Oh my gosh, that's so many terms. X squared plus XY plus XZ plus Z. So many terms. What are we supposed to do with this? We're gonna keep it in its factor form. Notice here, always be on the lookout for patterns. X plus Y, X plus Y, X plus Y. Why did I just point to three X plus Ys? Y minus X, Y plus Z, X plus Z. I'm just gonna rewrite this equation. I'm just gonna switch the order of the two terms. Can you see it now? I'll do it again. X plus Y, X plus Y, X plus Y. Y minus X, Y plus Z, X plus Z. Do you see what's going on here? Well, the key idea is you're going to subtract these equations. X plus Y, and then Y plus Z minus X plus Z is Y minus X. And this is 32. Aha! This is exactly what we want to find. So the answer is just 32. Although we just did one simple step, figuring out to do this was definitely not easy in the slightest bit. You have to notice the patterns and figure out, and despite it being such a tricky seeming problem, one simple yet powerful step completely trivialized this problem for us. Again, the key idea, look for factorizations, and then notice how, no, look for patterns, right? This was the main pattern that we needed to see. Okay, another problem. This one from BMMT. Let x and y be real numbers such that xy4 and x squared y plus xy squared is 25. Find the value of that. Okay, so let's just go back here a little bit and show you this list of techniques I have. So, of course, you know substituting variables, elimination, those are the ones you know. And there's some other key things like using symmetry we just discussed, and adding, subtracting, multiplying equations that are also often helpful, like we just saw, and difference of squares, like we just used. And binomial expansions as well are very useful, right? X plus y squared, x squared plus 2xy plus y squared, x minus y squared, x squared minus 2xy plus y squared. So these are the main techniques, but so now let's see how we can approach this. Xy, x squared plus xy squared. Xy, x squared y, xy squared. You can factor that indeed. This equation can be factored. XY times x squared y is, well, notice how x squared y is just xy times x. And xy squared is just xy times y. So we can factor this as xy times x plus y. And xy, and we know this is 25. XY is 4. 4x plus y, 25. So x plus y is 25. By 4. What is that? Let's see. XY, XY, XY. XY, they all three have XY is factored. So essentially what I'm saying is we can again rewrite it as in terms of XY. XY times X squared plus XY times X y plus xy times y squared. And this is just xy, x squared plus xy plus y squared. Cool. And we know xy is 4, right? So this is 4. So we want to find the value of this expression somehow. But what is this? I mean, x squared plus xy plus y squared? I mean, oh, should we find that? Okay, so let's keep in mind what we do know. We do know xy is 4 and x plus y equals 25 over 4. And the key thing to notice here, x squared and y squared. So these are basically our only two conditions to work with, right? We've already converted this condition. We've converted the this condition over here into x plus y equals 25 over 4. So somehow we have to find this expression using these values. X squared, but this is just this square term. What? How did we get there? The square term is the key here. And one way to get a square term is by squaring something, right? So what should we square? Well, notice that we can square x plus y. Remember the binomial expansions? X squared plus 2xy plus y squared. Aha! These are the same, right? Oh no, they're a little bit different. They're only different by xy, which we know the value of. So, let us square, just to be clear. X plus y squared, that's 625, that's 25 over 4 squared, right? We know 25 over 4, that's all squared. Okay, and what else? That's going to be 625 over 16, right? But that's x squared plus 2xy plus y squared. That has an extra xy term, so all we gotta do is subtract 4. That's minus 64 by 16. 625 minus 64, and a good way to do this is saying 65 minus 100 is 525, and then plus 36, that's 561. So 561 over 16. So this part is just 561 over 16. 4 times 561 over 16 becomes 561 over 4. Wow. Another reminder that you don't have to solve for every individual variable. Even though this time we got two variables and two equations, this would be quite a nightmare to find the value of x and y of. Instead, clever factoring and then noticing patterns, noticing our conditions. And a good strategy to keep in mind is looking for the conditions you have not used yet. Almost always you're going to have to use all the information in the problem. So look for what you haven't used yet, if you're ever stuck. So we factor this, we got this value, xy we found, okay, and then we notice the repeated occurrence of this xy, so xy, 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 xy. So that, again, pattern finding. So we factor this out, we factor that out in terms of xy, and then we notice that this binomial square expansion, we found the value of this expression, and we just solve from there. Let's take a look at some more interesting systems of equations problems, but now they're disguised in terms of words. So this is the one, literally the most common topic on the AMC8, and it's not always that easy to figure out the equations from the words, but it is with the right strategies and techniques. We'll explore that right there.